straight away, a result, almost a result. Garmini Silva has moved away from the stumps and has made a late call. Kamran Akmal had almost completed a single. He's staring at the umpire. He doesn't know what has hit him. Yes, he's not going. He's looking around. And let's see, did he get an inside edge to this? Lovely seam position. Just came back. Huge inside edge. And umpire Garmini Silva didn't pick that up. So Kamran Akmal is disgusted. He's got every reason to be disgusted. He's still looking around, but he's got to go. He's gone for a duck. And Pakistan have lost a wicket in the very first ball of the innings. And Silva is off to a very ordinary start here, Garmini Silva. Still waiting for that replay to come on the big screen. Oh, great shot. Now that is one class act from Imran Nazir. He's a good hitter of the ball, a free flowing player. This time edge and gone through Sangakkara and Mahila Jayawardene. Sangakkara went partially, and so as a result, first slip had no chance. Slip standing closer to second than to first slip. Genuine edge towards it. And in fact, Jayawardene, when he saw Sangakkara coming, started moving the other way, giving the keeper some room. Sangakkara should have gone for it fully. That's another cracking drive. He's off to a remarkably great start. 3 fours, 3 and a 1 to end the over. 3 boundaries. Oh, nicely driven, this time straight through mid-on. Chase for Ajanta Mendes, and would you believe it, Sanath Jayasuriya beat him in that race. Ajanta Mendes must be about 30 years young. That's gone, dismissed from his presence. He is good in that area, Imran Nazir. You provide him with and he'll pounce on it. Top of the order, because the field is set in. He can be himself just like that. Just a shorthand jab. Magnificent piece of cricket from Imran Nazir. He's ruling the roost and enjoying it as well. More runs. They did fine. Mendes gets there. Not really. Ball boys do the fielding.
A big shout, and up goes the finger. Very good stuff from Mendes. Brought into the attack early, inside 10 overs, and Imran Nazir was playing very well indeed. He's now on his way back.
He was looking to play toward the mid-wicket region. That was plumb, no doubt about it. No doubt at all. He'll hit middle stump halfway up. That's a huge wicket, big wicket. Gone for 35, it's 45 for 2.
Inside 8 overs, Mohammad Yusuf is the next man in. Oh, that's not a bad shout either. There's that sliding down, there's a little bit of a shake in the head that time. The Sri Lankan players. Now, Kumar Sangakkara, when you see the replay, you'll see that he is dead in line with the stumps. He hasn't...
Unbelievable, that looks pretty plumb to me. Ooh, would have hit the leg stump, I would say.
That's a very good shot. That's not a bad way to get off the mark eventually. That's going to win the race. That's not a bad shot either. Shaking head this time. I think a reasonable stride down. Hitting on the roll, maybe the top part of the roll, but a good stride.
Oh, just height maybe.
Good shot though. Worked that one across leg side. He's got himself a nice little boundary.
Driven beautifully. That had everything. Timing was perfect. But Yunis Khan could unleash that kind of strokes. Just that he needs to sort of trust himself. And very nearly a wicket. I'm surprised he dropped it off his own bowling. Because he's an excellent fielder.
moving like a 40-year-old. Oh, that really would have been a story. I will 100 out of 100 for a commitment.
Smashed before. That was short and outside your stump. Spinners looking to get some measure of control, but this is a good shot. Chopped behind point. Matthews again. But this time, he won't stop it.
He's got that away for a couple, might even got four, it does. Good shot, chipping over the top of extra cover, and that's gone for four. That's well played, very well played indeed. Bound off the first ball of the over. Of cricket. Big shout, up goes the finger as well. Son of Surya struck. The grandpa of cricket has picked up a wicket. He'll be delighted with that. He's done very well in the field so far.
One tempting delivery outside the off stump. Got a little bit of extra bounce perhaps. Hitting almost the shoulder of the bat. Yusuf for 43. And Pakistan 113 for 3 now.
Game. Overall strike rate is pretty good at 81.7. He's hit that beautifully. That's a very good shot. They needed that boundary. That's what they needed. Pakistan though are getting a little bit behind. Little paddle. Reverse paddle. It's going to run away, I think, for a boundary. Or is it? No, it's not. It's going to slow off a little bit. It does. And then result is they come back for three runs.
Played that reverse paddle very well.
Obviously, if either Afridi or Mark will get going, they might even get well past that. I'm sure still in the back of their mind, they're probably talking about the 280 mark with a little bit of luck. A few more than that. So a couple of runs there for the skipper. 51 now. 37th ODI 50.
Maybe take on the Sri Lankan bowlers, but that was a good shot. Now you'll need more shots like that from his bowl hug, and he has the capability to do it. Once again, this is a great shot by Yunis Khan, who split the gap between mid-wicket and mid-off. They should go for four again. This time it was missed bowl hug. Little closer to him, and he just that split the gap beautifully. Well timed his bowl hug. It's a good delivery, a big shot for a catch behind. Sangakkara is very confident. Garmini Silva is not interested. Well. What's happening here? The Sri Lankans are very confident. He can't believe it. Let's have another look. There must be some noise. That's why Sangakkara just went up for it. What's happening there? Not really sure what exactly is happening, what they're talking about, but Sangakkara doesn't look very happy. I think he's not happy because Yunus Khan, straight after he got beaten, he said something to the umpire. He said, or he just suggested that he didn't nick it or something like that.
Terrific one day cricketer. Good Yorker bowling. That one sneaked through. It's Prasad who's given Sri Lanka things to smile about. Yunus Khan was a major irritant in their way, and he's been deceived by a very good Yorker. As Dhamika Prasad has got one to sneak through. Good in swinging Yorker, right on the block hole from the Pakistan captain. He's now gone for 76, and Pakistan 196 for 4. Of 84 ball effort between Misbah and Yunus Khan. Goes big. Fielder is in business, and he's taken at long off. Matthews tells him to please go back to the pavilion. Who is perished trying a big shot, big six. caught on the boundary. Well, Judge, that's what you can say, because the rope is just behind. It's always a bit of a distraction. It's always on the back of your mind.
He's come possibly just at the right time. Afridi sent back. And that ball will go across for a four. It hit his back. It wasn't really required from Mahela.
Gone, caught behind. No problems for Kumar Sangakkara. Problems for Shahid Afridi. And problems for Pakistan also.
Page has got to now deal with the situation.
Eased on the leg side. I think it's just going to be the one. No, they're coming back for the second as well. So that's 50 for Misbah. Strike rate's not bad at 82. That's pretty close to his career strike rate. His ninth one international 50. So five overs remaining now. And obviously they have to take the batting power play. Simple as that. He's had a dip at that. That's gone a long way. That's a good strike. That's a very good strike indeed. That's gone for half a dozen. That's beautifully played. That's what they needed. Good connection. Very good connection. That's a great shot. Wow, that's a beauty.
A huge six.
It is in the air and it's nicely struck. That's going to go for four. That was the error. Almost in the block hole, but Hammond straight back past the ball for four. That is a terrific stroke. That's beautifully played. What a way to start the last over.
Always believe that Misbah ul-Haq is a powerful striker of the ball.
Nine actually. Full toss. Heavy back. High in the air. Is it going to be taken? Yes, it is. Tarang is the man. Cool, calm and collect underneath that. That's a wicket that Shalaib will be happy to...
The 33. 274 for 7.
Two balls left. Straight drive, and that's very well struck. That's going to disappear for a boundary. Again, not quite getting the ball in the block hole and punished. Last ball innings. Again, it's a half volley and it's disappearing very quickly across the field. They're surely going to come back and try and pick up the second. They do make it, I think, or do they? That's going to go upstairs.
Oh, that's so very tight. I think he's just gone. He's gone. He's just sort of
heightened a little bit. 50 overs, 279 for 8.
Today, given to him by his captain.
Lovely shot, outstanding shot.
That'll settle the reckoning in the mind.
Pulled that as well, and that's gone for four. So two wides earlier in the over meant two extra deliveries of the death, and they both went for boundaries. 11 off the over, 15 for one.
So. Difficult proposition for Pakistan. There he goes over cover. Announces himself in no uncertain terms. Flashing drive from Sanad Jayasuriya.
Slow ball that time, and it's going to be taken quite easily in the end. What a comeback from Rana Naveed. He is absolutely delighted that he's picked up that wicket. That was really good thinking. It was a ball of just
nine, and he was gone.
Premies, that is such clever bowling. It's unbelievable the control he has out of the back of the hand.
Can he? He's gone for six, 19 for two.
There it is, batting at number four this time for Sri Lanka. Oh, it's in the air for a while, but it's running away for boundary. That's right off the blade. Not a bad way to get off the mark. End of the over, 23 for two.
Sangakkara has looked pretty cool out there. He's only faced a couple of balls. One of that delivery went for a four.
Short ball, top edge. There is a man down there, but he's not going to be near it. And it's bouncing just inside the rope. Oh, is it? It's been given six. Six runs it is off the last ball of the over, so 10 runs off that over.
The last delivery of the last over. Top edge for six. But good mix of slow deliveries from Rana. And also some pace.
Goodness me. Bit of action. Imran Nazir two wickets down already, 36 in the ball for Sri Lanka. Kumasangakkara just hitting that one straight towards him and just not quite carrying.
They needed for top, one of the top ones to score runs. No ball. This might come handy. That didn't happen, so they probably look to build a huge partnership between these two. If one of them goes
to go.
Smashed it. Made use of the no ball free hit. Slower delivery drive by running Navid. Sangakkara picked it up. Hooked away. Now the fielder can't get to it. Well played by Mahala Jayawardena. 50 for 2 after 9.
Also.
Nicely played. Once again, well timed into the gap. This is a fast outfield that will race away. Four more to Sri Lanka.
So quickly.
Could be out. Could be out. Gone. Shahid Khan Afridi was the man who caught it. Another one, slow delivery once again from Navidul Hasan Rana. And Kumar Sangakkara is gone.
Had to get runs for Sri Lanka today, but he again is gone to a leading edge, just like Sanath Jayasuriya a short while ago. Afridi accepts it gleefully. Simple catch. The captain's gone for 16 and Sri Lanka 54 for 3. Kumar Sangakkara, it's brought Kapugedra to the middle. Good delivery to end the over. 10 gone, 54 for 3.
With the bat, hot candidate for man of the match rewards.
And this is disappointing. Mohammad Amir has got the wicket. Sri Lanka lose yet another batsman, but this has been a good performance by Pakistan. What a tremendous fight back in the series.
Produced this form early in the one-day series, this series would have been such a great one. But nevertheless, this is an extremely good result for Pakistan. Getting rid of Mahela is not an easy job, but he's gone. And with him, possibly the hopes of a Sri Lankan victory. He's gone for 31, 58.
He doesn't have a great, he doesn't have great experience in this form of the game. And off the edge, he's got it slipped. The fifth Sri Lankan wicket is gone. Chamara Kapugedra. That is...
The writing is on the wall for some of them. This really was a smart catch. That ball went very swiftly to Miss Balhak, gathered it with both hands. The body language is great. They want to win this to prove a point. Mohammad Amir, what a sensational star is turning out to be for Pakistan. 3 for 27 in 7 overs. Kapugedra gone for 1.
And with Sri Lanka in serious trouble.
Mahela Jayawardena, the last man dismissed. Oh, that's a lovely drive. Kandami has played a stunner. And not at all in favor of Malinga. Caught behind, another one bites the dust. Best figures for Mohammad Amir, his fourth wicket. He's the latest smiling assassin. It's Matthews is gone. Lanka.
They've been slashing outside the off stump, yet another batsman. Playing at a delivery well wide of the stumps. Fairly straightforward chance to the keeper. So Angelo Matthews, the batsman, dismissed. I'll bowl Amir for 5. Let's not forget that Monday is a working day here, so they don't want to get too late. They want to have a good night's sleep, I guess.
Another edge and brilliantly caught by Misbahul-Haq. He's been in great catching form. Rana Navid picks up his third wicket. What a night he's having. Yunus Khan to bring back Mohammad, bring back Rana Navid. Have a look at this one.
This is unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Sri Lanka just losing it.
But a target that could have been achieved on a pitch like this. That's gone through. He's bowled in to pick up his 100th ODI wicket. He's been a sensational inclusion for Pakistan. And have a look at this one. Nice and straight, came back just a little, rattled the stumps. He picks up his fourth and 100th one day international. Rasad goes for 1, 74 for 8.
The Dusra. There's a bit of coaching going on this morning. Muralidharan, of course, a master at the art. Alongside Ajmal, trying to get some lessons.
Yes, good to see a legend just maybe teaching him few tricks. That's the respect he's showing.
2020 game, that's going to be lots of fun. Pakistan have got some good form. Down the track, he's hit it a long way up. This is going to be a tough catch in the lights for a while. He's put it down. Shahid Afridi it is.
A little bit unlucky there. Bandara looking to go over the top. Maybe the extra spin they need to side Afridi. He was looking to go
into the attack for the first time. Smack that away. One bounce four. Ajmal again. Down the track. Up in the air. And over the top of the man at Menon and racing away for a boundary.
Quicker. Did he miss the ball? Did the ball hit the stumps?
This will tell us the better story. There you go, it's stumped. Or maybe run out because he's too far away. He's gone for 31, it's 145 for 9.
Play around a little bit. In the air, it's caught. Thick outside edge, Afridi finishes all for Pakistan.
Well, then, Yunus, another good night for you guys.
Actually, you know, when we played day-night games, you know, it's good for us that the morning games, you know, always we are struggling. Maybe we are not awake or something like that. But it's good because winning the toss and then put 280 in the boards is always good, especially the these kind of pitches, you know, and under light is very, very hard to chase. So I think, but again, we are just, I think we have not enough runs in it because, you know, in one stage, it looked like that we will be past 300, but suddenly we are again collapsed, but the end, and it was good.
Some bright performances from some bright young players. You would be pretty happy with how Mohammed Amir and Umar Akmal performed in this one-day series.
Yeah, and I'll say Ajmal as well because he's also the is not young, but internationally he's young. So I think these three performances here, it was very fantastic for us.
You about that wonderful catch that you took the other night. Everything is stable up here because you hit the ground pretty hard.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, I'm okay now.
Making more sense. Well done.
Thank you very much. Run and...
$5,000. Honorable Minister will give him the check.
Throughout the one-day series, when the senior boys failed, the young boys dovetailed, played well, and I've been saying it for a long time, but they've got amazing results.